What happened to all these orphans and foundlings? This is part two. If you haven't seen part one, it is part of the whole thing, so better you watch it. In the first part, we already announced what we're going to look into, like how many are there really, impact and consequences, what happened to the non-white, because in the first part, we showed a lot of pictures and situations of the white orphans, but there are many more, of course, non-white. Why and who paid for this foster care, education, food, clothing, etc.? Why orphans are useful for the governments? The mental state and trauma when they are grown up? And who is orphan, foundling, adopted, growing up without trusted tribe, to not say family? So if you look into the most famous one, we find everything, yeah? Mandela, Genghis Khan, Malcolm X, Darwin, yeah, with his fantasy theory, Mercury, Selassie, politicians, musicians, inventors, dictators, yeah? And then, of course, the whole Hollywood is full of orphans figures. They are all orphans, and they are mostly they lost their mother or cry after their mother. Of course, a huge benefit to put that into the brain of the children already. So it become already like a subject that is where we saw the movie, etc. But even Aristotle, Isaac, Voltaire, even Julius Caesar, or many would say no, Moses was not because he went back. But same story. Or dictators like Bolivar, artists, Warhol, or Nietzsche, like philosophers who put brainwashed or manipulated people in when they are adult. We have what they call the Middle Ages. They accepted many things, like the people lived in ghettos, so they had to find these incubators. Like in why nobody was shocked about it, it's because there was so much going on. And so much harm and poor people and slums and ghettos. And that's why even people was not surprised to have human souls. Yeah, this is where they came from until 1960. Human souls. Yeah. Where they exposed it. And of course, this World Exposition always was part of this whole thing. The largest human soul in world history. Even in France, that was... Yeah. So, these incubators was not really something surprising. They had so no respect from nothing, and mostly not after children. So, already in the first, we touched a little bit the question about how many are they really. And we put this graphic, and some comments were like, yeah, but you say there's no overpopulation at that 8 billion. And then we show this graphic. This is just to show what they are showing. Now, if the number, these are estimated, they only estimate. But let's now say we are way less than 8 billion, and this number would be correct. There would be way more, and it would shock people way more. So how much they really are? Who have the answer? We don't have it. We have no clue. We never count all these people. And to make fantasy theories about it, will bring nothing else than more confusion. So the question have to be asked differently. Instead to make analysis and probabilities, is everyone who have a birth certificate is today considered an orphan? Yeah, and anytime celebrating the birthday makes people to slaves, because a certificate is only for a product, and this is how people get slaved. And it starts already in a hospital, because hospital comes from hospitalis, yeah, and the hospitalis, they was the Templars. If the computer will not stick no more. Hospital, shelter for the needy. From old French, hospital, hostels, shelter, lodging. From French, hôpital, hospitale, guest house. Known for neuter of Latin, a guest house or host. A guest, a duty of hospitality. From hospes, ghost, host, see, host. So let's see, host. We always think this is about the needy. Yeah, it's about to get. Today the hospital is something where ill people get sick people get their treatments. And treatment is to treat the illness, not to make people healthy. So host, person who receive guests. Guest, host, landlord, a multitude, especially an army organized for war, a strange foreigner, an enemy, body of Christ, consecrated bread. Sacrificed also, animal sacrificed, victim, yeah? And this, again, this hospitalis was created by the Templars, by the Knights Hospitalis. And that's why also like the whole Masonic charity is coming into place. All the Shriners who take care of the children. And we will see also where this all is coming from. And of course the whole charity is then used for any kind of purpose, like for the biggest pedophile known pedophile, Jimmy Savile. And of course, behind all that, the Catholic Church. So what this have to do with the orphans? Well, the thing is that we are considered like a lost shipping on the sea. That's why they always use this maritime law to use us as a merchandising lost on sea. So that's why they also put it on the newspaper and to say like we have a lost item, to say who is this item, and if nobody come after 7 days, the parents will come and put the certificate on it and register the kid. So now, birth register, UNICEF executive the director, a child not registered as a at birth is invisible, non-existent in the eye of the government and the law. That would be perfect. And they say a quarter of the children remain invisible. 20% of the past decades, yet 166 million children under 5 have never been officially recorded. They have no clue. They have no register. And they don't know how much people are really there. And again, here, if you just, they want complete now registration for all these birth to make all this birth certificate, but look, UNICEF states on the world states of the world children base mostly on household service and Ministry of Health data. That's just a service. Estimations. They have no clue themselves. So the question is, what happened to all these orphans? Because in the last video we talked about where are they coming from, but the question is also what is going on after or when they are getting adult. Yeah. So also there we have a huge variety of different cases. Yeah. We just take examples. I mean, you can research this all for yourself if you want to know more about it. We just give different examples, but there are way more cases than what we are showing here. Under the program, that 130,000 children were sent to a better life in former British colonies, mainly Australia and Canada. From the 1920s to the 1970s, the children aged between 3 and 14 often faces a life of servitude and hard labor in foster homes. And so now we're coming to again back to the Industrial Revolution, and what we didn't show in the first part is like how much children were really used to make this Industrial Revolution. And some of them say there would not be any Industrial Revolution without the children labor. So just one example again.
A rumour circulated that there was going to be an agreement between the overseers of a workhouse and the owner of a great cotton mill. The children were told that when they arrived at the cotton mill, that they would be transformed into ladies and gentlemen. That they would be fed on roast beef and plum pudding and have plenty of cash in their pockets. In August 1799, 80 boys and girls who were 7 years old became parish apprentices till they had acquired the age of 21. The young strangers were conducted into a spacious room with long narrow tables and wooden benches. The supper set before them consisted of milk porridge of a very blue complexion. Where was our roast beef and plum pudding?
That was the con played on 8-year-old Robert Blinko, was told to a journalist several years later. He was bound apprentice to a spinning mill like this one. This is Quarry Bank Mill in Cheshire, founded in 1780.
It was built out in the sticks because it needed the river that runs through the valley to power the machines inside.
The downside of that decision was that remote places like this were low on available manpower. So who would staff these mills? Who would do the work? The solution was to recruit the most vulnerable elements in society. Orphans. The first wave of factory labour in this country was made up of orphans.
They were the real life Oliver Twists, left to the mercy of the parishes.
And their employment was nothing less than state-sponsored slavery.
State-sponsored slavery. Another part of this documentary. No, 80.
But that industrial future needed feeding, and children played a role in that too. We tend to think of children from this time as working in mines and factories, but in fact, child labour was ubiquitous. Almost every workplace would have had children in it. And the biggest employer was actually agriculture.
Agriculture accounted for about a third of children's jobs, often on small setups like this one. This farm was attached to the local rectory and worked by a small team, including boys and girls.
Of course, agriculture is one area where we still see children working today, ushered into the life of the farm under the watchful eye of their parents. The children of the Industrial Revolution rarely enjoyed such a gentle introduction. Unlike the factory apprentices, child farm workers were often the only children employed on an establishment. And they were also housed with their master or another adult worker. And there was no one looking over the shoulders of these men to see how they were treating their child employees. As a result, these children were often more vulnerable than the children who worked in factories.
Yep. So this is where our where the Western culture and the generations are coming from. So child labor, hard work, yeah, no pay, or really little pay, dangerous, hot condition, no rights, poor pay, dirty workplaces, long hours. And of course, also in the mines, they was working everywhere. They were was working everywhere and used as slaves, even in these factories. And they had to wear no shoes because in these factories, it would make spark and everything would burn up. But they had long hours, and they also, because they had little hands and size was a little, they was the only one used in these factories, and then the ones who watched over them. So already in the time, of course, people didn't, some of them didn't agree, either they pushed even further. And that's why also they brought up children a little bit from everywhere. So, but they start already, not everyone was agreeing. I mean, they had some who didn't agree, who talked about it. Yeah, it's like today, it's not gone, but almost forgotten. There's another story about in Canada again, and we go into why Canada and Australia so much. Canada mourns a remain of 215 children found at the indigenous school just beside. And there was quite a couple of stories about Queen Elizabeth visit this school. But again, this was a huge distraction from what was really going on. The Queen and the Prince did visit Kalups twice, once in 1959 and once in 1983, according to the official records. USA Today found no records of the Queen Elizabeth II and Prince Philip visiting the school or taking a group of children at the picnic. So this whole story is about, we don't defend the Queen or what whatever, but in this case, it is a setup, because why would the Jesuit making a statement following the recent discovery at the former Kamloops Indian Residential School First Nation? On behalf of the Jesuit Canada, I would like to express my deep sorrows of grief of shocking discovery on the remains of 215 children on the grounds of the former Kamloops Indian Residential School, because they having participated in this system ourselves, the Jesuit. So we don't really need to search further what was really going on here. And even they take a lot of effort to make reconciliation with the Indians in general when they abused just all of them. And so we are coming to also the question of the what happened with all these non-whites, because the whites, they would maybe get care and so on, but a lot of the non-white children, they try to re-educate them, and this was what re-education comes from, or education come from, is to treat them like animals. So, of course, there are huge parts in all over the world where they are just abuse and use these children to make them good slaves. It worked on some places more than less. But again, the Jesuit, on May 16, 1993, Kolbach, Superior General of Society of Jesus, issued apologies for the action of Jesuits in the Western Mission and in the way the church was intensified toward the tribal custom, language and spirituality. The Society of Jesus is sorry for the mistakes it has made in the past, but it just makes the same still today. And again, we are just giving examples. There are millions of examples. Another example is Operation Baby Lift in Vietnam, where they just took children to America in carton boxes and flew them to America. And today, the international community want to arrest Putin because he took over children out of the war zone in Donbass to bring them to Russia, and many of them, they are already back there. So again, this hypocrisy of what is going on, and none of the war, none of the displaced children, none of this should happen at all. Just to say that the hypocrisy of who is the good guys and the bad guys and playing out this shit doesn't make any sense. Native American reservation in the continental United States. I mean, there was everywhere before. Yeah. And today they have just this little reservation. This is what they want to do with the 50-minute city with everyone. Yeah. And the same in Australia. Yeah, here all the invaders live here around, and they have all these reserves in the middle where nothing is growing. So of course they tried also use them as slaves. They didn't work with Aborigines at all. Yeah, tried to re-educate them, give them, school them, the children. Again, take the parents, the children, separate them. And this is what we can find today. Yeah, slums and ghettos. So to find a better life is always a complete different story when it's really happened. The mental state and traumas. I mean, this is a very important subject in this whole thing, because today we have a complete different view of children, and it's already changing. Today's, for many of the end-time fanatics, even having children is a diabolic sin in their climate religion. But still, for many, a child is an innocent being who needs a warm, healthy, empathic environment to grow up with a healthy mind. But also this idea and the handling is in many ways catastrophic. Yeah, try to protect the child, make it good. We just want the best for the child, and finally you have a spoiled, destroyed kid. First reaction of mishandled, traumatized, unconscious child when being adult will downplay the abuse they have been subject to themselves. And even defend it as, that's nothing. Many today still justify physical punishment. In many countries, is even legal and advised by officials to do so. So if you think, the spank as a child, I just deserve it. The question is, how come that beating an inoffensive child as an adult should be okay? It is just cowardly. Let's name it. It is child abuse. If an adult hit a child that cannot defend themselves. So traumas and from physical and mental abuse will leave traces. The one will remain the whole life if they are not entirely healed, meaning recognized, comprehend what, when, by who, and why what happened, and letting go entirely. Until it's all cleaned from emotional attachments to what happened in the past. We grew up in and lived 16 years in one of these schools with many different children from social standards and many with huge traumatic backgrounds. And already as child, we saw the difficulties many of them had, also because as son of the director, we had, of course, more insights in what happened to many of these children. And therefore, we had a huge background, have a huge background of observing and analyzing human behaviors and also the traumatic side and how the children cope with traumatic situations. So when we talk about traumas that can happen, or the sources of it can be many different causes. Confused family situations, abuse, mental and physical violence, divorces, separations, death of one of the family members, and the orphans, all these foster care, education camps, the foundlings, and also the adoption. And adoption also is for many things that, yeah, there's something good, they have a better life, blah, 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 blah. Always this, they have a better life, have to be questioned, because who can predict the future for anyone? But taking them away out of their environment and put them into a Western, completely different mindset, and try to adapt. We saw many of them, and it don't have to be confused all the time. Many times it can happen, mostly when they have contact with their remains with their family, in their countries where they're coming from. It can come out quite okay. But they are traumatized. They are detached from their sources, from their tribe again. So also then, of course, also bullying, punishment, mental or physical, or if they get abandoned, neglected, rejected, all this thing leave traces, of course. And many of these orphans and foundlings, they were declared mental ill and medicated. And here we have one of these examples where they call the term doublesis, orphan, referred to the cohort of children who suffered particularly with traumatic abuse at the hand of states of the Catholic Church. More than 20,000 illegitimate children of unmarried, often young women, were born in Quebec between 1949 and 1956, wrongly certified as mentally ill and confined to psychiatric institutions. Many of these children were deliberately miscertified in order to acquire additional subsidies from the federal government. And this still happens today. This is why when they take children away from parents and put them in foster care, they get money. So again, to have a mental ill patient, they get more money out of it for their orphans and so on. And here an example, we have to translate, because it is Quebec, Quebecois, and it doesn't translate, it's not really French, so that's why we will translate quite a bit.
C'est vrai que notre subconscient, il capte tout. Il capte tout, 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 tout.
She said that the subconscious get everything. They try to make it to forget, but she remember like everything, and they also get the documents, what really happened there.
Puis tout m'est revenu à pleine face. Ils ont dit dans mon dossier pourquoi qu'elle a doublé sa deuxième année. La réponse en bas, c'est marqué, elle ne comprenait rien. Comment vous voulez qu'un enfant...
She had to double the year, and that's why they say she didn't understand anything. But she was 7 or 8 years old.
Puis je comprends, à l'âge de 7 ans ou 8 ans, se faire maltraiter à coups de barreau de chaise sur le dos. Parce que...
They beat her with an iron chair on the back. 8 years old. Because she didn't write on the line straight, and that's why they beat her. A little further, not far. Just here.
On faisait une dictée, et puis c'est vrai, je faisais beaucoup de fautes. Elle avait une oreille qui avait du fer dessus l'oreille. Puis elle m'a donné un coup sur...
If they didn't write correctly or making grammatically faults, they get hit on the hand.
Mais, ow, ça fait mal. Ma mère, ça fait mal. Est allée,
not the balls. She's not, she didn't say that. Said my mother. Yeah.
Elle est à son pupitre. Puis est revenue avec un bâton. Aujourd'hui, on peut appeler ça un barreau de chaise.
Yeah, with a stick and.
Là, elle m'a donné. Je mettais ma main comme ça pour pas pour ma main, mes bras.
Yeah, she had to protect herself.
So, puis là, elle m'a donné sur la tête, m'a donné sur le corps. J'ai tombé en bas de ma.
Yeah, she fall down the chair.
De ma chaise du pupitre. Puis là, elle continuait à varger sur moi.
And she was on the floor and she got kicked.
Des coups par terre que même j'ai. Que j'ai fait pipi dans ma culotte.
Until she pissed in the pant. Let's go a little bit further here. Another testimony from another guy.
Ils m'ont envoyé à Saint-Michel-Archange de Québec. Je ne sais pas si vous avez connu ça, c'est l'hôpital psychiatrique.
Et moi, they send him to a psychiatric hospital. He was an orphan. He was not anything like that, but they just send him there.
Je ne sais pas c'est Michel Archange. Je sais tu, moi j'ai dit, je vois une grosse boîte, je vois des messieurs qui partent seuls, puis des gars qui font des gestes. Là, il y a marqué dans mon dossier un peu débile.
So in his dossier is written he is stupid.
C'est que deux jours après, il me refait manger devant le conseil des médecins. C'était tous les gars.
So he had to go in front of a couple of psychiatrists. He said they are as much crazy as the ill in there, the doctors.
Puis bien, c'est eux sont aussi fous que les malades que là-bas. Ça fait que là, ils ont dit, ils commencent à lire mon dossier. Hein, il a déserté des institutions. C'est un petit gars qui était dérangé.
Just because he escaped from foster homes and he was like making trouble and he was a rebel.
Hein, puis tout ça d'affaires de même pour que je sois interné.
Comme de... All that he gets interned in these foster homes.
Le docteur, il a bien marqué la deuxième fois que j'ai passé, c'est vraiment un débile profond.
So the doctor writes on the paper like he's like really a deep idiot.
Là, j'ai commencé à avoir des traitements.
And then they start to give the treatments, medication.
Là, j'ai eu la première pilule que j'ai eue, c'était une...
They give him a Lagatil, make him to a zombie.
Lagatil. Puis prenez jamais ça parce que ça fesse. T'sais, on est comme zombie, là, puis...
Well, he tried to not take them.
Il y a un gardien qui est arrivé devant moi, il dit, essaie de te dégourdir un peu, il dit, rends-nous des services, Joseph. Hey, j'ai su que tu servais des messes.
He was serving the mess. So he was the psych, the idiot who had to serve the mess.
Mais pour un débile mental, servir la messe, j'avais dit ça à la soeur. Elle dit, laisse faire le débile mental, tu vas servir des messes. Je vais essayer de rendre service, mais j'avais mes médicaments, c'était fort.
He had to take medication and they were strong and so the brain was foggy.
Donné que j'ai jeté un médicament, là j'en pouvais plus. Oh, mais là j'étais 2 jours dans une cellule.
He was placed in a prison cell.
Lagatil, du nosidam, puis gardonnade. Au 5D, il y avait un dortoir, c'était des handicapés, ils faisaient dans leur lit. Mais c'est nous autres, les malades, qui changeaient les malades. Les gardiens qui étaient assis, puis nous autres, ils venaient qu'à s'entendre, ouais, qu'est-ce qu'on fait.
Yeah, let's skip a little further here. I mean, it's catastrophic what they did with all these children. Yeah.
J'ai appris les mots, c'est sodomie.
So he learned the word sodomy. The word, not only the word. Look at all these children.
Elle s'appelle Thérèse de la Croix. Ça, c'est la sœur qui m'a fait la plus souffrir à Saint-Michel. J'avais jamais raison. C'est nous autres.
Yeah, one of the sisters, how they call it, was one that was really mad with him.
Amen. Puis t'es ici pour te faire soigner. Puis s'il faut, tu vas mourir ici. C'est là.
You're gonna die here, she said.
C'est la sœur que je critique, parce que les autres sœurs m'ont pas magané. Là, elle a donné l'ordre aux gardiens de me punir. La punition, pour le moment, c'était l'humiliation.
Humiliation, of course. Yeah.
C'est, ils nous déshabillaient. Là.
They take the clothes off.
Puis après nous déshabiller, j'ai vu des gardiens qui.
They touched the children.
Qui ont fait des drôles de touchements. Ils m'ont serré comme de.
Squeeze the genitals.
Les parties là, tu sais là. Puis j'ai eu un coup de pied là. Là, j'ai tombé.
And they kicked him in the balls.
Terre, puis là, j'ai eu la camisole de force parce que.
And he fell on the floor and they put it in a straight jacket. Because he resisted.
Il est attaché sur un lit.
And attached to a bed.
Moi, j'ai voulu savoir, puis c'est de même que j'ai su que Joseph venait de là, puis qu'il m'a emmené là, j'ai vu la sœur.
That was the woman now she's with, and they went visit, and they comprehend that he came from there because the media was started talking about it. And she went to the one that was really the most brutal with him, and she asked some questions.
La sœur m'a dit, j'ai dit pourquoi j'ai dit que vous le mettiez dans des cages que.
Why did you put it in a cage?
Vous le mettiez avec la camisole de force et tout ça, hein, Joseph, t'as fait ça. Elle dit, oui, mais madame, il s'évadait, j'ai dit.
So she was escaping. So, she, what?
Elle dit, il s'évadait, j'ai dit, donc, vous dites, c'est un prisonnier. Ben, elle dit, non. C'est des prisonniers, s'évadent, ma soeur.
Yeah. Only prisoners escape.
Puis il voulait savoir, j'ai dit, pourquoi il n'y a plus une dent dans la bouche, cet homme-là?
Why he didn't have any teeth anymore, she asked.
Ben, elle dit, comptait assez de mensonges, elle dit, fallait bien le punir d'une certaine...
When enough lies, they need a way to punish.
De toute façon, chaque mensonge, elle faisait enlever une dent.
But each lie, they took out the teeth.
Une journée, j'ai posé la question. J'ai dit, Joseph, réponds.
She asked if he was afraid of them. Yeah, well, of course he was afraid of them. So this is, again, it's just one example, and it happened, like they said, to many of these children, yeah, thousands. And this was just, again, one of these particularly thing. So all what they have, like the effect of the survival, separation anxiety, abandonment issues, abandonment child syndrome, social anxiety, insomnia, eating disorder, depression, substance abuse, post-traumatic stress disorder, abandonment, received attachment disorder, psychopaths. This is how they create psychopaths. And again, this is what creates society today. A lot of them, they're coming out of this. And today, it's the same thing, like reward and punishment. And again, as it's going down into generations, this is what we have today. And again, it don't have to be with everyone. We can stop it. We can stop the things from just going further. So why and who paid for this foster care, education, food, clothing, etc.? Before the church took over, it was the corporations. And corporations, we will go into what corporations is, and then the church take over, and finally the family. This is how it went from 1700 to today. So let's go into corporations to better comprehend what corporations is. Under ancient regime in France, a social organization that grouped the members of a profession from the bottom to the top pyramid and call it corps de métier. So you could not buy or sell or work without a corporation. This is what was the standard. And these corporations came out of what we call in the last videos, the tribe. The people had this kind of, they had their own rules, they had their own moral code, they had their own care for the children, for the illness, the sick. They had like health care. And so on. And this is the same like Freemasonry. They have apprentice, they have follower apprentice and master. This is how they worked. This was the corporation. And this corporation also worked in many different ways with like the Freemasonry works today. That's why also people was accepted in going into Freemasonry. But just to comprehend what corporation really means. Yeah, person united in a body of some purpose, assumption of a body, use of the incarnation of Christ, body, dead body, animal body, also whole, composed of units, part, a structure, system, community, corporation, political body, a guild. And this is what it was attached to a kind of labor work, carpenter, masons, yeah? And the masons, there was, it get fictive, yeah? Once the Freemasonry get the way to make to building, they start to build their mine. But the corp operation also, this the corp is a dead body, a dead body operation. So it means it is already, you are into this whole slave. And they had their priests, they had their own religion, they had and so on. So it was something people was holding on. So when they disappeared, the disappearance of the guilds, however the guilds became a minority, that's not true, that was made again. In each trade, social conflicts increase, abolished by the Torgat's edict in 1776. They disappeared definitely under the Constituent Assembly reform in 1798. The abolition of the master degrees and jurors law of March 1791. And now we have to comprehend why this happens, because what many people know about Illuminati, the Illuminati that was in this time, but it was the illuminated ones. It was the kind of the ones who followed the light. Yeah, it was this whole witchcraft that was in France, Spain, and in all over Europe. That was the whole thing behind this whole idea of the light, and they infiltrated through the Freemasonry. And if you look the time, yeah, it was 1717. Four lodges which had existed for some time became together in Gnosis. This was the first real lodge that was created of Freemasonry, like of this fictional Freemasonry. And from there on, they start to infiltrate all this corporation to make it disappear and get the minority until they forbid it. And this is also the reason why they could, why the whole uprise were coming, where they just create the revolution. And just one more thing to say, what we didn't say before, is like the Freemasonry or this whole Illuminati thing is to create individuals, yeah? So it was there was no personal ownership and all this stuff. The people get individual. This was individual. Yeah, this was how they divide people. This is one how they want to make it, because they had their own police. These corporations had their own police, their own thing. You could not rule them. They ruled themselves. So they had to make them disappear so everyone can have these human rights, da-da-da-da. Yeah, this was how this is transhumanism, is exactly the same idea of the following up of this illusion. But just to comprehend, there many things that came together, why the people are participating in the revolution. They thought they had something to fight for, because they want the corporations. And finally, is also to comprehend why people went into Freemasonry, because when it was this guild was forbidden, the only thing that was left that seems to be like something like a corporation was the Freemasonry. And that's why also the idea of communism came. This is the source of the communism. It wasn't from these corporations. So once they start, and they're always in the same place. I mean, on both sides, yeah? Like the Protestant and the Catholics, the Protestant, they was created by Catholics, of course. And also directed and so on. Also to play also always the duality one side. So all this whole communism, this Antifa, this whole idea is socialism and so on, come from there to get back to this kind of cooperation where people are working together and take care of each other. What was already, of course, a confusion, because the cooperation was already a confusion of the tribe. Not to say the corporation was the tribe, we have to go back to corporations. That's crazy shit. That's communism. This is what how I want to make it. So they went from one ideology to another, and like today, they're going into transhumanism. This is very important to comprehend what really happened in this whole thing. not just to see, oh, they are the Freemason. This is of course completely different, and they also infiltrate through the whole occult stuff and the whole Egyptian and Templar and so on. But we can already see they had already their symbols, their gods, their religions, their hierarchy, and so on. This was the same thing. And that's why also, why Masonic make charitable have foundations. Here, just another example of a Freemasonic children home, yeah, full display, not hide it. But this is why also people still, or so many taking part in this whole Masonic stuff. This is because they think they will go back into a kind of cooperation where people take care of each other. And then you have all the abuses with it, of course. When we come to the church again, we have the Knight Templars. This is a military order. Military order. They have nothing to do to heal people or to take care of people. And again, Loyola University of Chicago, History of Catholic Orphan Homes in the United States from 1727 to 1984. So the church was in charge mainly then of all the orphans, and they grew all over. They had these Catholic orphan homes. And until today, the Jesuit High School of New Orleans making the sign of Baphomet in full display. They are really happy about it. And then the family came. Yeah. So, of course, as we already said, the family, the invention of the family, we had that in the last videos, but we're going to put this once again. The origin, meaning of family, servant of a household. Family servant, slaves. So this is what the family is. And therefore the family became the one who, through the certificate, who have to take care of the children in how the government tells them. So the parental responsibility to protect the child from harm, to protect your child with food, clothing and places, to live, all good, support your child financially, provide safety, supervision, and control. So you, the parents, became the controller. Provide medical care, yeah, like the jabs. Provide education. Education means training of animal, yeah. So they became the foster care guardians. And if the parents don't do what the state wants, the police come and pick up the children. So this is the situation that we all consider legally orphans. So why orphans are useful for the governments? And we would have to say why orphans are useful for the system, not only for the government, because healthcare, for making a lot of money and so on. So abused children are always profitable for the system. They want abused children. Institutions were viewed as advanced over the colonial conditions of relief provided for the children, which allow them to be housed with the adult criminal and deviant. And there we come again, Canada and Australia. What is really happening with Canada and Australia? And we also could see always in both videos we had a lot of examples about Canada and Australia. There was penal colonies. Both countries, such as Canada and Australia, were used as penal colonies to which the colonized countries, France, England, sent their common law offender that the ladder of hopes to build a better life in this new world, which seems to less hostile than the institution of the time. So both countries are a mixed up of orphans and criminals. This is what the background they have. And that's why it is also no wonder how they are today, with through the whole pandemic and the whole laws and what they are really doing with the thing. They are penal colonies. They can do everything what they want. And people are used to it, this punishment and this kind of restriction and this stuff. And now again in Australia, they do it like through the COVID time. They have roadblocks. They are already starting their 15-minute cities, and people are not really waking up there either. So that's also a reason why Canada and Australia were used so much as even today are very much used as a New World Order training camp. That's why they made so much restrictions. Creation of this institution was a way in which rich could exercise control over the poor. Many believed that punitive conditions and isolation from family made possible to institutionalize would coerce children into obedient labor market behavior. The function of children institutions were trained, rehabilitated young people and provided the model for the moral reform of society. Yeah. Labor market conditions played a significant role in growth of institutional care during the 19th century. Industrialization and mechanization eventually reduced relative demands for unskilled child labor. Yeah, so they have to take care in another way. At the time, vast numbers of young people were entering the country as immigrants. The net effect of these trends was oversupply of children labor. Communities became concerned about what to do with this youth. Thus, institutions were created to house children who were not needed in the labor force. Yeah? So again, the ones who are not used in the labor force, they get the education. Still don't change today. And families taking care that this all happen. So one thing we talked a little in the last videos, and also you can go make a lot of research about this. We just mentioned it really shortly. It's about the stork and the children, and why this fantasy of the stork providing children. And there we can also find more in the ideology of occult. Stork to many cultures and a sacred bird is lavished with symbolism. Stork are the sworn foes of snakes, haze of veneration in which they hold. Storks are also ancient fertility symbol and are typically associated with springtime and birth. They are assembled immortality and longevity, vigilance, completion, prudence, pity, meditation, and chastity. Christians regard the stork as symbol for Christ and his disciple because it was the terror of snakes that represent Satan and his demons. And so you have it also here, a swan with young broad pecking her breast, the jewel of the rose croix. There we are back on the Jesuit again. So again, with all we saw now and the condition of what orphans, foundlings, adoption, and so on all brings, maybe we comprehend better what is really going on and why it is going on this way. If people are used and abused in this way and why they have so funny theories and skills. I mean, you know, this is another thing. We have a lot of this genius, like if you take Skrillex or Steve Jobs or whoever, they have skills because they have no purpose in life, so they have to create a purpose. That's why they get so skilled, and they in many different ways. And this, of course, the system know how to use this, and to brainwash the children with orphan stories all over. They will also easier accept to become the orphan themselves and make their own children to orphans. And also, when we have any kind of theory and any kind of fantasy or philosophical bullshit art, we have to question in what kind of mindset the people are doing this stuff. And again, we are not victim. Victim means a living creature killed, offered as a sacrifice to a deity or supernatural power, or in the performance of a religious rite. Sacrificial animal, person or animal killed as a sacrifice. A word of uncertain origin, perhaps related to vices, turn occasions, as in vicarious, if the notion was exchanged with the gods. So again, we are not victims. We are fully responsible, and this is the only way we will get away from this whole bullshit. And this is, as long as people are feeling being sacrificed for their God, they will not take responsibility. So we can definitely see how Freemasonry pushed the individualism away from the corporation, who was already a wannabe tribe. The source of today's disturbed mentality is this individualism. Individe you all. They want to divide us, to rule. Before, people did not own personal stuff. Everything was on disposal for everyone. Today we get owned by our own stuff we own. And we also can see that the whole socialism fantasy is also coming from this corporation or lost tribes, the Antifa, all this to the whole New World Order. Wants to get back to some kind of ideologic they are not able to remake, to reconstruct again. So therefore, it's important to realize that the bullshit that is going on and to stop the cycle and not playing victim. So again, in support, we have this channel here. We also, you will find it also on YouTube. We will put some links under, and there you can find more stuff about this whole history, lost history stuff. We'll provide for it. So there we are. We don't know if there will be a follow-up or something on it, but for the moment we'll leave it here, going into other directions. But thanks for watching.